Good morning, ladies and gents. How you doing? And today I'm getting a little bit funky with this old lady here by the name of Junko. I call her Junko because she is technically junk. I got her on an auction and it said that she was a Greco JB450. Admittedly, there was a question mark next to that. It's like the person wasn't quite sure what it was. But anyway, 1970s era, probably mid to late 70s. Certainly the neck is a Greco neck from that period. The body, we're not sure if it is, but the body is not the original body that would have come with this neck. There are various things that tell us so, such as the bridge not being in the right place and aligning with the pickups properly. That kind of thing gives it away. So it's a component bass. All the parts are Japanese. They're old. They're from the 70s or early 80s. The tuning pegs have been replaced. But the thing is, she plays great. I had to work on her a little bit, had to adjust the bridge position a little bit. But she works great. Let's just put some chords down on the rear pickup, and I'll do that with the tone up. Make it a little bit funky. There we go. Yeah, that's nice and funky. Alright, and then conversely, let's turn the tone down and do some swells just for some atmosphere. Whoops, I talked over the top of that a little bit, but that's alright. There we go. So you get an idea of how she sounds in all of those atmosphere. Actually, sounds fantastic. I'm just going to put that in the background there. She actually sounds fantastic. If I go on both pickups and play some slap. Awesome. That was with the tone right down. I turn the tone right up. Very bright with the tone right up. Now let's go on the rear pickup and with the tone down. I love the rear pickup sound on this. Now, I had to replace the rear pickup because the pickup that was in there was not right. It was too small and somehow they crammed it in there. I don't know what happened to this bass, but anyway, I don't know what happened to all the original parts, but anyway, fact of the matter is that I've got something here which is now a functional junk bass, and it's actually quite nice. So let's have a listen to the rear pickup. That's nice, isn't it? Lovely, and then if I turn the tone up, that's amazing. It's just so bright and really has that that great burp on the rear pickup. Cool, it's really cool. And then the front pickup alone, do some slap. So that's nice, and then with the tone up. Yeah, it's insane. So there you go, and I'll just fiddle around on the rear on the front pickup in finger style. Brilliant. Listen to how clear that is. It's just the intonation is fine. Atmosphere. despite, you know, the bridge having to be relocated and everything, the intonation sounds fine. Like, when I play the chords, nothing's weird. Sometimes when you get basses where things are not quite as they should be, or the neck is not the original neck or something, you know, the intonation is almost impossible to set up right. But this one, despite being component bass and technically junk, actually it works very well, I'm pleased to say. So there you go, that's Junko-chan, and she has the, I think the circuitry is original under the dial plate here. Looks like it. Good quality parts, and the front pickup is original. It's nice. I think it's Greco. Like I said, I replaced the rear pickup with a Fender Japan one. It's working nicely. The neck, I believe, is Greco from the 70s era, because it's a three-piece neck that you see on the 70s era basses. In the 80s, most of their basses, I think they started using just one-piece construction then. So this suggests that this is a 70s era Greco neck. The body, I don't know, to be honest. It's not, I can't be sure. Weight wise, you're looking at about 4.2 kilograms, or maybe 4.3 on this. A little bit weighty. The body seems to be constructed of maybe a laminate on top, an older laminate, and then a basswood body, and then an older laminate on the back as well, I think. Which I guess that's just a cost-cutting measure. Anyway, it sounds pretty good, especially on the rear pickup. Really nice. Rear pickup sounds awesome. So there you go. She's actually quite a beauty. I'm very impressed with the neck. The truss rod is fully operational. The neck is very flat. The action is very low. I've got it right down. So, I mean, none of that stuff is a problem on this bass. Intonation. Intonation is fine. The intonation just works fine. I'm very surprised, actually. The only problem that I find with this is the alignment of the pickup. Because the body and neck are not the original ones, the alignment of the pickups is not good. It's running over the poles, but it's not running between them perfectly. But as you can hear, it still makes a good sound. Makes a good sound. And that's what counts. Thank you. She actually plays beautifully. Very surprised. Did take some work. I'm glad I put the effort in. I was gonna give up and not do anything. And just sell her as parts, but I'm really glad I put the effort into trying to reposition the bridge to make it align with the neck better. I also had to adjust the a headstock. They tried to enlarge the holes in here to accommodate these different tuning pegs, which are not the original ones. And god damn it, I mean, they'd done just a butchered job, you know, terrible. So I tried to enlarge them a little bit to make the bushels here sink in properly. It's much better than before, and it's holding its tuning. So that's good. Thank you.